Hi, my name is Hannah Paget. I'm here at the History Pavilion near the River Market in Little Rock, Arkansas. The piece of art I'd like to show you today is an untitled 1975 wooden sculpture by Peter Wolf Toth. This sculpture is the 13th in a series called The Trail of Whispering Giants. This series has at least one unique sculpture dedicated to the local Native Americans in each of the 50 states and several Canadian provinces. Interestingly, Toth carved each of these sculptures free of charge because he felt a kinship with Native Americans since his Hungarian family was also oppressed and driven from their home by the Soviet Union. Artistic ability also ran in the Toth family. His father was a practiced wood sculptor. Toth describes himself as a self-taught artist who was inspired by his father. Toth's greatest influences are from the Native Americans that he depicts, especially those from the pre-Columbian period. Toth's highly stylized work is similar to the Ponce Stella of the Tiwanaku People's Temple. Toth's preference for using wood as a medium and his simplistic style are reminiscent of the Haida and Tlingit Indian tribes' totem poles in Ketchikan and other northwestern coastal areas around Washington, Oregon, and British Columbia. This particular sculpture is 20 feet tall, made of oak, and is meant to be a composite of all the Native people of the state. The unnamed and a highly stylized Native American features all of the identifying characteristics of an Indian: the defined high cheekbones, prominent nose, feather headdress, and braided hair. A closer look at the eyes reveals only the barest outline with no details such as pupils, irises, or even eyebrows. The braids and feather headdress are also formed using primarily simple geometric shapes. Though Toth didn't use many fine details in this piece of art, the downward strokes on this Indian's face shows much emotion. The elongated face, regal features, and expression in the eyes and mouth give the impression that this Indian was a weathered and somber being. I chose this specific piece of art for several reasons. First and foremost, I love this sculpture because of its simple complexity. Though this piece is the extreme opposite of intricate, it somehow embodies and symbolizes many emotions and ideals. Secondly, the artist's story and connection to the Native Americans is a touching and captivating one. But since my family is descended largely from Cherokee Indians, I find this tribute especially poignant. Thanks for watching, and I hope y'all enjoyed my Art You Can See Today video.